Janet Evans is an Olympic legend. She won 4 Olympic gold medals in swimming. She even beat the mighty East Germans, cheats and all, in Seoul in 1988 and then retired in 1996. But now she's making an extraordinary comeback. And joining me now, the woman who many believe is America's greatest ever female long-distance swimmer, Janet Evans. First question, why are you doing this? Why, you've got more medals than probably only Michael Phelps can beat you. Why are you doing this?
You know, I'm 40 and I...
Exactly! Retired gracefully like you did 16 years ago.
Well, you know, I retired. I did everything I wanted to in the sport of swimming. And then I wanted to do all the things you want to do when you're 24 years old, which is when I retired. So I saw the world. I got married. I had babies. And a couple of years ago, I thought, well, gosh.
And you got bored.
Yeah. Yeah, I just decided I wanted to do a little something for myself, too, at the end of the day. And I think a lot of mothers go through that. And when I put my head down on the pillow, I wanted to feel like I was a good mom and a good wife, but I also did something for myself. So I jumped back in the pool.
How much of it was linked to the fact that, unusually, in your discipline, the longer distance swimming, the times hadn't got much faster? Yeah. So you're looking at this thinking, 16 years have gone by, but they're not much quicker than when I was at my peak. And actually, your weight is more your fighting weight today than when you retired in Atlanta.
It was. So I'm about 15, 20 pounds lighter than when I retired in Atlanta in 1996. And the times I was swimming in the 80s and the 90s, they're like not that close to them. So it was always in the back of my mind. And then I got a call from my coach 2 summers ago and said, they're not swimming that fast. You're in pretty good shape. You're looking good. What do you think about this? And it had to be my idea, but it was always as I watched the times and they never got faster. I mean, if the girls were swimming 10, 15 seconds faster than I used to ever be able to swim, I would be sitting there with you, you know?
It was strange. I mean, if it was the 100-meter sprint, then Usain Bolt is so far ahead of everybody, would have been 16 years ago, that you wouldn't even think about trying to come and compete against him. Why have the times not got faster?
Well, I think distance swimming is a really hard discipline. You know, I mean, I'm in the water 5 hours a day. I swim 10 miles a day. It's boring. It's monotonous. It's a lot of work.
You swim 10 miles a day?
I swim 10 miles a day, 6 days a week. And so to swim the distances I swim, that's what I have to
do. In a pool do you train?
In a pool. Five hours a day in the pool.
How many laps is that?
Well, 30 laps is a mile, so 300 laps. Of an Olympic pool, the big long one.
Up and down a pool 300 times a day?
Yes.
Yeah. Is that not boring?
It's boring, but it's also time to myself with no cell phones ringing or texts going or kids asking me for things.
As you're churning away, what are you thinking?
Well, sometimes I think I'm crazy, but most of the time I think, you know, it feels good. It feels good to be in shape. It feels good to be doing something for myself. It feels good to have goals again and improve. I improve every single day. When I was swimming in the 80s and 90s, I broke all my world records when I was 17. Mm. I swam for 7 more years. I never did a best time. And as an athlete, you want to improve. So I'm certainly not swimming as fast as I was in the 80s and 90s, but I get faster every day.
Is part of it also that Atlanta wasn't a huge success for you compared to previous Olympics?
Yeah, I think that was a part of it, actually. I always say I was very happy in Atlanta. I was happy because I got to retire. You know, I had worked so hard. I'd swum so many Olympics. I had a lot of pressure on me in Atlanta. I didn't swim as well as I wanted to. And I feel like there were things I could have done differently. I think in Atlanta, my mental attitude wasn't great. I just wanted to be done. Mm-hmm. I was excited to be done with the sport. And I never really enjoyed it towards the end of my career because I felt this incredible pressure. So now there is a little pressure, but there's not that much because this is all icing for me. It's never going to change what I've accomplished. They're never going to take my medals away. This is all kind of
no. I mean, let me play devil's advocate. You can slightly tarnish the legacy. And the reason I say that to you, in Atlanta, you had an amazing moment. You handed the torch, the Olympic torch, to Muhammad Ali. Now, that wasn't the Muhammad Ali of 10 years before. Everybody knows that. You know, he's an astonishing, iconic figure, but he fought too long. He had too many fights. When you see somebody like him, as a sportsman yourself, is the resounding lesson to just know when to stop?
I think we don't know when to stop. I think it's in our souls. I think it's a part of who we are. And I think if any of us think that we even stand a fighting chance, it's what we do.
I mean, you're not going to get slugged around the head like he was, but you could get badly beaten by people who in your prime, and you know, you might say to me, you could still be in your prime, but most experts would say at 40, you probably can't reach quite those heights. If you get badly beaten by a young whippersnapper, how are you going to feel?
I'm going to feel okay. Are you? I am. I totally am. And you know that I'm a huge competitor, and you know that I don't like to lose, but I also get to
even
go,
when your husband beats you at Words with Friends, apparently you don't talk to him all night.
I know, because I'm a competitor, but I also think with age comes wisdom, and I think I have really good perspective. I really do. At the end of the day, I go home to two great kids and an awesome husband who happens to beat me at Words with Friends. but, you know, it doesn't change who I am. And I
What times are you doing at the moment?
I'm going about 840s in my 800, so I have some time to improve before trials. What and not
you,
that much time.
What do you Before the trials, what do you need to get to?
I think I need to go in the 820s. 824, 823.
Can you do that?
I don't know. And I think the age-old question is going to be, did I give myself enough time? You know, Ian Thorpe just missed the Australian team a few weeks ago, and his comment was, I didn't give myself enough time. I didn't train long enough to physiologically get my body in the shape.
Are you training as hard as you did at your peak?
I am training as hard as I did. Actually, I think even better because I'm more motivated, because it's more fun for me, because it's finite. I know there's an end to it. So, yeah, I'm training better, and I'm enjoying it.
What does your husband say about all this?
He thinks,
be honest, was he pleased?
You know, I think he thought I was a little crazy at first, but he's really supportive of it. You know, he helps out with the kids a lot. He's been, you know, he's always amazed. He said every morning at 4:30 the alarm goes off, and I think to myself, oh, just go back to sleep. He goes, and every morning you get out of bed. It amazes him. He can't fathom it, but I really think that's because athletes have different mindsets than other people. It's why we do what we do.
Is there anything quite like the buzz of winning a gold medal? Is this part of the thing? Is it like when boxers tell me, like great champions, Lennox Lewis, people, when they walk out and you have this incredible atmosphere? Nothing in normal life is ever quite as exciting as that. I can't imagine there are many things that are more thrilling than the starting gun for an Olympic final.
Yeah.
Or winning one.
Well, the pressure is incredible, much more than any other kind of athlete as an Olympian, because it's once every 4 years. So if you can't perform in that moment, in that given moment, it's four more years. So, there's, you know, I think as a parent and as a mother, there are many more moments in my life that have become much more significant than winning a gold medal, you know, being a parent, first and foremost.
I'm worried about your imagery today.
My imagery.
Well, because you're basically trying to compete with the fastest swimmers in the world, and you've got snails all over your top.
Actually, my husband said that to me today.
It's not a very threatening imagery for your rivals.
But you know, it's like under the radar, you know? So, wear snails, but then I swim fast enough. Should I have like sharks or dolphins or something?
I think something a little bit more a little bit more speedy, you know?
I know. I kind of
like little cheetahs or something.
Yeah, but it's cute.
Talking of cheetahs, you took on a lot of cheats. The Eastern Europeans at the time were riddled with cheats, as it later emerged. Yet you still beat them. I suppose the obvious question to me is, if you're good enough, does it really matter? I mean, obviously it matters to the credibility of the sport, but do you believe if you're essentially a great athlete, you can always beat cheats?
I think if you have the mindset. You know, when I beat the East Germans, I was barely 17, and I didn't think about it. I didn't consider what they were doing. It just didn't enter my train of thought. So I believed in myself. I mentally believed what I had done. I mentally believed in my training, and I was able to beat them. So, you know, I think if you have the talent, if you don't let them play mind games, you know, I think it's focusing on who you are as an athlete and what you've done and believing in yourself.
I get the feeling America needs these games and needs to be incredibly successful, needs to beat the Chinese, needs to beat its rivals comprehensively in the great sports that American athletes have always prevailed at. Would you go along with that? Do you get a sense that American morale needs this?
You know, I would, but it's funny. Having swum in the 88 games, which was the last, you know, Olympics of the Cold War, that was when I sensed it more. You know, that was kind of us versus them, the East Germans versus the U.S. And as a young person, not knowing so much about it, going to those Olympics and realizing that it was us against them in the Cold War, that was when you really felt this need to beat them. Now I feel like the Olympics were all, you know, especially in swimming, it's not the East Germans and the Americans anymore. The Chinese aren't very good at swimming, right? The Chinese have their days. They have their moments. They have their years.
Will there be any Chinese swimmers in the final against you?
Oh, yeah. I think there will be. I'm not sure in the distance races, but in the sprint races, the Chinese are swimming really well. But in swimming, it's all countries are doing really well now. not just these Germans in the U.S.
The Brits aren't bad at swimming.
The Brits are doing really well. And they're going to be in London, so how can they not do well?
The weather will be terrible.
Yes, but it's indoors. Of course, it's in Britain. Of course, it's indoors.
So we can't use that as our usual excuse.
Exactly. Exactly.
What do your kids make of it? Are they old enough to understand what's going on?
Yeah, my five-year-old is old enough. I asked her the other day if she wanted to swim. She's a good little swimmer. I put her in for water safety, and I said, do you want to join the swim team? She said, am I going to have to get up as early as you? And I said, no, I don't know, maybe. She said, no, I don't want to swim. So, but she understands that I'm swimming, and she asks how swimming's going. And my two-year-old kind of, you know, he doesn't really get it. But I hope one day it inspires them, especially my daughter, that their mother can go out and do and be what she wants to be and also come home and be a good mom. And
if you win gold, Janet, is that it?
Yes. Even if I don't win gold, this is it. I'm going to sleep in after this. And
it's one last comeback.
I'm going to do something else to stay in shape.
Like what?
I don't know. Something that doesn't involve chlorine and swimming every day and 4:30 a.m. wake-ups, but something else that doesn't make me so competitive. Because if I swim, I have to compete. It's all I know.
Well, look, the American dream was built on people who just never give up. I think there's something very romantic about your story. Wish you all the very best with the trials. And if you get to London, I'll see you there.
Sounds good. It's a plan.
Best of luck.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Janet Evans, completely mad, but also a brilliant swimmer. So why shouldn't she?